Hi, I'm Eli Silber. I'm a neurologist based at King's College Hospital. My colleagues and I, a few years ago, helped to set up a stem cell group for London, where we're trying to choose the most appropriate people for treatment with stem cell treatment for their MS, and also to support them during this treatment. Because I think that it depends on appropriate selection and support and monitoring to make sure that we're getting right with what is potentially quite a potent therapy. So we know that all of the MS treatments that we've got to date are immune-altering, all of the disease-modifying therapies, and one needs to remember that stem cells, the way that they're being given, is exactly the same. That what we're doing is we're altering the immune system, we're immune-suppressing patients, and we're using stem cell therapy as a rescue therapy after patients have had immune suppression. There's also the potential that the stem cells may help in some way with regeneration, but that's speculative at this stage, and some of my colleagues in this country are doing experimental work to see whether this is in fact the case. So the people that we're recommending for stem cell therapies are patients with aggressive, relapsing, remitting multiple sclerosis who've been treated with potent disease-modifying therapy and have got evidence of failure of disease-modifying therapy based on relapses and particularly new MRI activity on their scans. The other group that we're looking at potentially is some patients with very aggressive, progressive multiple sclerosis where there's high inflammatory activity, new lesions on their scans, and we're looking at that to see whether there is the potential for benefit. Now, at this stage, we don't know if the stem cell therapy is better than existing potent therapies, and there are trials that are being planned both across the UK and a large multinational trial to try and assess this question, comparing it to best available therapies. And at this stage, we don't yet know. So at the moment, we're using it as rescue therapy on a compassionate basis for people with the most aggressive disease, trying to offer them the best that's available. What's essential is that for all of the people who are treated, it's important, these are valuable, precious patients, we need to follow them up for their own safety, but we also need to follow them up to get good data so that we can try and work out who's most likely to benefit from these therapies and to look at the risks of treatment. In terms of research into stem cell therapy, I think one needs to look at it in two areas. The first is benchwork experimental therapy, where some of my colleagues are taking animal models, human tissue models of multiple sclerosis, exposing them to stem cells and seeing whether stem cells promote regeneration and remyelination. And that's very important work. The other work that's being done in terms of multiple sclerosis research with stem cells is proper randomized control trials where people with MS are being randomized to either get treated with stem cell with immune suppression and stem cell rescue or the best available current therapies. And only with proper selection, proper randomization, and very good hard MRI and clinical outcomes are we going to be able to tell. So there's a mixture of clinical research, phase 3 studies pragmatically done, and benchwork trying to see whether stem cells encourage remyelination.